How's it going?
Pretty good.
You got it out pretty quick.
Yeah, I got it out quick, man.
I appreciate it, man.
All right, no problem. Here's your keys.
Awesome.
Enjoy it.
Thank you, sir.
All right, buddy.
Take a good one. Just dropped it off.
What's going on, guys? My name's Eddie, and welcome to my channel. In this video, I want to show you guys my first motorcycle that I just picked up. It is the brand new 2019 Indian Scout Bobber with ABS. This bike is so sick. I'm so excited about it. I haven't really had a chance to ride it as much, but I'll be doing that in a little bit, take you guys around town. But first, I want to talk about the bike, what I like about it, why I picked it up, and give you guys a quick walk around just so you can see what the bike looks like. So about a month ago, I was on a market for my first motorcycle. I was mainly looking for cruisers that's within $10,000-$15,000 range. I don't want to break the bank on my first motorcycle, but at the same time, I wanted to get something that I know I wouldn't outgrow in about 6 months or a whole year. After looking around, I found that there are so many different options within that range. We had the Harley 48, Roadster, Iron 883, Kawasaki Vulcan, Honda Rebel, Triumph. All these bikes were beautiful, and after looking around, I found the Indian Scout Bobber, and I just love the overall build of the bike. So after looking around, I've narrowed it down to the two. It was the Harley 48 and the Indian Scout Bobber. Why I chose the Indian Scout Bobber over the Harley, I'll talk about in another video because there's actually a funny story behind it. But overall, like, I haven't had a chance to ride this bike as much. Just going off of how it looks, I love the way this bike was put together. The stockiness, fat tires, the aggressive look, and it just suits my style overall. So like I said, I haven't really had a chance to ride the Bobber as much, but I did do a test drive at the dealer before I picked it up. My first initial thought was the Bobber was really quick and it was nimble, and that was enough for me to like it over the other bikes. And I figured whichever bike I brought home as my first bike, I'd be happy with. But I just couldn't pass on the Bobber because I do love the overlook of it. Like I said, this bike is pretty sick. Set him, stop talking. Let's go take her out for a spin.
All right, well, fully mounted. Let's go take her out for a spin. Oh yeah, this bike feels good. All right, so I don't have a GPS. I don't really know where I'm going. I'm just gonna follow the road and see where it takes me. And also, I was told not to go above 5,000 RPMs until it's fully broken in. So I'm gonna try to stay away from the freeway and just kind of keep it around town. Oh yeah, this bike handles so good. Yeah, that could have been trouble right there. There's a construction site, and luckily the brakes are pretty good. And the car next to me was fighting for that lane, and so I just decided not to and stopped completely. But that was a good brake check. Brakes work. Man, look. look how beautiful this place is. If you're wondering where I'm at, I'm in Las Vegas. I know it sure don't look like it, but yeah, we got some greens in Vegas. Something about riding a motorcycle is just so different and satisfying compared to being in the car. And this feeling alone makes buying a motorcycle so worth it. It's crazy how I can cruise at highway speed in third gear. This bike gets up to 60 miles per hour in third gear. To me, that's crazy. Oh man, I love this bike. This bike is awesome. And I don't even know where I'm at right now. Tropical? All right, let's go follow Tropical. The reason why I keep getting lost, or I'm still lost, is because even though I'm on this side of the town, or I live on this side of the town, I don't come here often. And directions and roads are different when you're in the car as compared to as being in a bike. And that's why I'm friggin' lost right now. And we're back. Oh man, that was a fun ride. Still got my signal on. Haha, noob.
Alright, so that was my first initial ride of this bike, and I gotta say, this bike is awesome. I love it. This bike has so much power. It's quick, it's nimble, and I was cruising at highway speeds in third gear. To me, that's crazy. This bike has six gears, and I believe the sixth one's an overdrive, but still pretty cool.
Alright guys, so for those who are thinking about getting this bike, I suggest you stick around and stay tuned, because I do plan on posting more videos of this bike just to give you guys an update of how it's coming along, how it's holding up, and how I feel about it in the long run.
So I hope you like this video. Stay tuned because I'll be posting more videos of my 2019 Indian Scout Bobber.